All right, guys, getting ready to start another really, really big repair. This one is. I think I was contacted about this one a little over a week ago, a week, week and a half ago. It's a big repair. Since it's dry now, it's a little harder to see, so I'm gonna have to kind of show you exactly how big this thing is here. And then I'll show you what I've got to work with and how I'm gonna fashion this carpet back together. It borders along the lines of full replacement, actually, but it looks like there's enough carpet for me to work with. So just tell you what I'm looking at. All right, I'm on the iPhone here because I'm not doing a huge long repair video. They don't get that many views. Basically, we've got a huge paint spill. It goes from here, actually almost to that wall over there, but you can't see it because it's white paint and the carpet has white accents to it. But you can feel it if you walk on it, for sure. So I've got all of this. It looks like it's gonna have to go to, it's definitely right here in the doorway. I have to cut right here. There's a little bit of paint right there. Seam is right here, I can see it. It goes back here. The last I can see of it is right here, which almost takes you to the wall. So I don't know where the paint was at when they spilled it, but it went everywhere. Wait a minute, no, I'm sorry. Here's a little more back here. And this is one of the ones where you could miss a little bit of it, or you could run out of carpet before you get it all covered. A lot going on here. What I bid it at is actually less than what it's worth, because to pay you what it's actually worth. All right, phone rang. Anyway, like I was saying, I bid it at less than what it's worth because, you know, if I actually charged everything it was worth, I wouldn't be here. I wouldn't be making this video. So, as I've said before on this channel, it's not all about money. It's not at this point for me. So I've got to hope this is wide enough and long enough. And as far as the carpet grain goes, it'd be great if it matched up, but you see what I'm working with, and you can only turn this about two different directions. Got another piece here that I may have to put a patch within a patch or something. Like I say with most of these, I will keep you informed throughout the whole repair and let you know exactly how this all finishes up, but I can't tell you how I'm going to do it until I'm done. It's just a matter of gutting it out, sticking to it, and doing what other people won't do. Most people won't do this. You know, you take the average carpet guy and you show him this, and they'll go, well, if you'd have called me before it dried, I could have got it out. Well, that's simply not the case. You've got to learn a little more about carpet so you can handle everything that gets thrown at you, if that's your intention. So I'm going to get to measuring, and I will catch up with the video here in a little bit when I've got somewhat of a plan put together here after I tape all of this out and see what it looks like. All right, update here. Let me explain. The carpet guys that are watching, they don't need any explanation here at all. You can see what I'm dealing with here. And she feels very adamant that she would like it to lay on the same grain, which makes sense. I actually, with a dollar bill, couldn't actually tell you without pulling the carpet back to verify that I was getting on the right grain. However, it is exactly what you're not looking for in this particular case. You know, you would love to just turn this guy sideways if that's not enough and patch everything in. But it looks like this is gonna take two separate patches. Yeah, and there's, looks like there's plenty to work with here. So at least that's in my favor here. So basically we're gonna go to the wall here, and then it will come out into here somewhere and get seamed in basically in there somewhere. And then after I get that piece laid in pretty, I don't know, pretty well where I want it, I'm going to then have to take whatever's left over and fashion another piece in over here. And I'll be holding everything together with nails until I actually, you know, get ready to start heating it with the irons. So this is not what you would call a picnic at work. This is rather difficult. It'll take a little bit. It'll be a lot of seaming. But, sorry, I'm glad I got a YouTube channel where I can show this to people. This is extraordinary damage. Anyway, I'm going to get to cutting here and kind of show you how all this, how this goes from beginning to end. All right. Hopefully that fan is not taking up too much of my voice when you can't hear me. Anyway, got it nailed in where the initial cuts are going to be made. So I'm going to do a little cutting here first. Honestly, I don't know. Maybe I'm going to lay that in place first and see just how that looks. But basically, when you encounter something like this, the first thing you do, and I'm fixing to do it here in just a second, is text my next client to see how they're doing. Because I know how I'm doing. I need to see how they're doing, because there's a chance that I might be late. There's certainly a chance of that at this point. So always text your next client when you run into something like this and see how their day's going and tell them that you just might be a little bit late getting there, because this is not going to happen in 30 minutes. All right, that's where we're at. Missed it by that much. So we're in about 3 patches, looks like, by the time I'm done fitting everything together. So even this guy right here won't speed up any. That won't speed up at all. I got this guy. All right. Let's see if I can catch you up here. Seamed in this one side here, and this little piece is going to get to stay. It's not seamed in yet, so I'm going to basically cut right here along the side right there or so, leave that where it's at, run the tape underneath it here. That side is just about complete, but as soon as I finish with this one seam here, I'm going to cut the irons off and then try to figure out these other two pieces that have to go in here and exactly how that's going to work. All keeping the carpet grain going the right way. I might need to check and switch that. Let me see here. Can't remember the arrow. Yeah, the arrow. Arrow needs to point that direction over there to be on the right grain. So, something to keep up with. You don't want to just fly through one of these as if you could. Anyway, be back in a minute. All right, little update here. This guy's, I don't know his name, but that's my helper. He's my buddy. He won't let you pick him up, but he wants you to scratch his ears. But he wants to lay on the carpet, and if you try to move him, he fusses at you. So he's good to have around, but he's not all that much help. But he's a good guy, though. He's a little on the fussy side. But he's got these cool stripes on him, so he's welcome to stay. Whatever your name is, little fella. All right. Let me know if I get in your way. All right, what I'm going to do here is I'm going to cut over there, cut that open, and probably I'm gonna have trouble cutting through that because the paint is so thick right there. So I may just kind of cut around this over here, and then I'm gonna be looking to take one more piece out of, I guess, here to fashion the last piece in to make this thing all come together. So, yeah, you know, I'm winging it. Or I might use what's left over here when I cut off of that, because I'm gonna, when I get that piece out of there, I'm gonna put this piece that you see up top underneath that, and then use my roll cutter to cut across it like that, so I'll have that piece left, and I know that the grain will match, and I may just be able to make not a full patch here, but a portion of that might be able to be put in, you know, something like that, if that makes any sense, in that area. It's completely custom. I don't know if you can call this. This is not a patch. This is beyond what you would call a patch. So, doing the best I can, because I don't think I've been in this situation before where I was asked to cut everything in two and put it together in pieces just to try to match the grain as close as possible. So, for now, that's all I can share with you. And I will be back here in a little bit to show you where I'm at. I've got it nailed. You can't even see if the nails are in there, but you know, I've got it. You don't want this to move when you go to cutting it, so you always want to nail this together, nail it down. But there's one right here. There's four nails holding this guy in place. And it may even need a little bit of a stretch when I'm done with it, because I've taken the majority of everything right out of the center of this room. So this is not your typical easy little carpet patch by any stretch. All right, I just wanted to update this because you don't see this every day. Managed to find a way to get this piece out of there. There's no cutting through it. So, got this out of the way, basically. Now this guy here, you know, this piece here, well, I'm gonna seam it in over there. And this guy here. And then, when I get to here, I've gotta make a decision whether I'm gonna put a whole piece in or just something around that area. But what I'm dealing with now is something I've never seen before. The carpet is actually painted to the wall. Just cutting through it here and pulling this part away was extremely difficult. So I don't know what I'm gonna have to endure to get all of this where the paint ran down into the, between the baseboard and tack strip and all that. It's painted in there, so. I've got to find a way to cut that out or dig it out, or I don't even know. But good thing I'm vlogging this, because you can't just call up somebody and go, "Hey man, let me tell you how my day went." Like, no, that didn't happen. All right. See you again in a minute. All right, still vlogging. I believe last time I checked in, I just finished that seam over there. So now I'm doing this piece here. So what I did was this piece was hanging over there. So I cut that much off it over there and left that much stick under it. So with that little piece, the little piece sticking under it, I couldn't fit the whole thing under there. I couldn't pick it up far enough, or I would have. But basically, I was able to pick it up far enough to shove just that little piece underneath there and then cut it to fit. So this guy's getting seamed in here. So then, basically, after I get this guy done here, I've got to decide what I'm going to do over here. And I've got, what have I got to work with? I've got this to work with over here and this guy right here. So I'm going to see how I'm gonna make that happen. And this piece was just nuts, man. This was, and it soaked all the way through it. So it's hard as a rock. And a while ago, I was moving some stuff around. And kind of walked over here. I put something in this room, and I found this big roll of carpet here. I'm like, what in the world? And that was the original piece I took out. I'm like, man, there's carpet just all over the place over here. And I realize I'm tracking back over my own work. So yeah, this is where that last piece is going to be sourced from to go right in there. So it always goes this way whenever I do a repair. It's usually something that's, you know, it's like this, something just grandiose, just crazy big. I remember, you know, when I first started, I started out with patches like about the size of my hand, you know, and I would carry these little templates around and we'd put them on the carpet and cut around the template and then take that template to the closet and cut around that template and then move the two pieces between the closet and the area that you were patching and just move whatever the issue was to the closet and move that piece out. That's basically how I got started doing repair, and it's always been seen from the top like this. So that's how this came about. I had a guy, he helped me for a little while, and he had done some carpet repair before, and he had done it like this. So that's how I started this, and this was way back in 2001, so there was no internet anywhere, but I've always maintained with this. Now, I don't actually have to do it this way on this job. I could just run the irons on the tape, but I don't have an iron that I feel comfortable putting in the glue at this point. So just staying with the top seam for this too. So as soon as I get something else done here, I will check back in and put you in a note. All right, down right to the wire here at the very end where this piece here is going to be put in here somewhere. So I've got everything else. It's not tucked in on that wall there. Everything over here has been tucked back in from where I pulled the carpet up to check the direction. A seam here, seam there. I'm gonna look at that seam again and reheat it and see if I can make it look better. I don't really care for that one. Everything else turned out just great. So when I get done, I'll be messing with this seam one more time to make it prettier if I can. And I've got to decide if I'm going to make it, you know, the whole, I mean, all the way out to here maybe, or I don't know yet. I've got to put it up there and see where I need to start making my cuts at. And next time I check in, I'll be able to tell you, but right now I don't know. It's just, I figured it out. So when I come back here in a minute, the second on your end and a little bit longer on my end. So when I come back, I'll be able to tell you more about what's going on. So be right back. All right. I had a phone call from one of my subscribers. So got to try to catch up the video here. Basically, what we've got the repair, it turns, it goes in here, and it turns and goes that way, and it turns and goes this way, and back that way, and then across. So this is just a ton of different stuff going on within this one repair. And this guy here is not actually touching. So what I'm gonna have to do is probably with a knee kicker, kick it over and nail it in place to get the little bit of slack out of it that's in it. And then I can finish up that little leg of the seam that I'm on. So just like I said, this is going to take a minute to craft together basically carpet, pieces of carpet to make one big piece of carpet. So this is a long way around, without a doubt. All right, I'll check back in a minute. All right, what's going on now is I'm seaming in the last little bit right here. And over here, what I'm doing is I'm warming that seam up to pull it back apart and to see if I can make it look the way I want it to look. I'm not happy with it, so it's gonna come back apart, and I'm gonna redo it. So, how you do it? Close to the end, but not quite yet. I've got to refix this seam, and then this guy is gonna need special attention. I can, let me see if I can show you. Yeah, see, right here? This carpet is so thick that it looks like it's touching, but it's not. So I may actually warm this guy up here and put a sliver of carpet probably between it is what I'll wind up doing. You know, cut a piece on the backing that's, you know, about that, that big, and set it in there, and then seam it all together from the top and get that to look the way I want it to look. You know, you can, if you're in a hurry and you want to, you know, scoot out on somebody, you can just pretend like you didn't see that and be gone, and there's a lot of that in the business, so I'm not that guy. All right, wanted to show this because I've never shown this before. When you take a seam apart, this is how you can take one apart. You basically heat it from the top and just pull it apart like so. So this piece is going to get a brand new piece of tape. I had my concerns that maybe a row of fibers or something had fallen down and was making one side, you know, slightly taller than the other or something. Not the case, but basically right here what happened was a piece of tape slid on me, I guess at some point. So it never got glued, so it was making the whole thing look kind of funky here. So I'm waiting for this guy to cool back off, and I'm gonna trim all that back out, and I'm gonna put a new piece of tape in there and re-seam this guy. And at the same time, like I said a while ago, I've got to take a piece of scrap over there, and I've got to fit it in here to finish this guy off. And at that point, I can close out the video and get out of here and go make another repair an hour away from here. So I'm glad I can share this with people so we can see, you know, whether or not you want to do carpet repair. Whether or not. All right, I'll be back. All right, this seam is going back together, and over here, this little piece right here got missed some kind of way, so I'm gonna dig around in there and basically put a little bit of hot glue in there. You know, be with the ice pick and everything to get everything positioned the way I want it to, and then drop a little bit of hot glue in there, and that will finish me up. So, what an endeavor. Kind of picky with my own work too. And a little bit, when I get done with this, and a little bit more past there, about one more iron's width. I would have used that iron, but I plugged my hot glue gun in over here, so any more than that, I'll probably blow a circuit breaker. Almost done. Over here, it's a little wet where everything was double seamed, but we're all good. Place over here where I can't really find it now, where I dug down and put my little piece in there, we're all good. But this is, I don't know what a good name for this, where this repair is. It's a lot going on. I'm glad to be finished with it. So you've got the big piece, you've got a small piece there, and then you've got a piece that fit in there, and this piece kind of goes into it like that. So it's just, there's just a ton of stuff that went on. Way more seaming than you ever want to do in a repair situation. It's difficult, and I like to take on things that are difficult, because when you get done, you get this feeling that I've got right now that, like, damn, I finished that. And I've also got video proof, so one of these days when I'm retired, if I feel like looking back at this, I can go, I think I remember that day that I did the longest repair in carpet repair history. So there we go. Glad I can share it with you guys on YouTube. All right, guys, I appreciate you watching this video. I've got to pack my stuff up now, and I've got probably about an hour drive back into Austin. I'm out in a place called Spicewood now, which is it's actually where Willie Nelson lives, right outside of town, outside of Austin. So it's about an hour outside of town. Got to pack up and drive to Austin and do what would be a regular type repair. Be another long night. But anyway. Thank you guys for watching. God bless, and I will see you. I may not do any coverage of the next repair. So, I mean, honestly, if I did, it wouldn't. What's the point? After seeing this, it'll be very uneventful. All right, guys. God bless. See you in the next video.